isolated areas and villages of the state. Unfortunately, this trend grew into full banditry from 2011, spreading into kidnapping, armed robbery, and other forms of crime. Consequently, the Zamfara state was forced into becoming the center of higher banditry in the entire northwestern region. Suffice to say, this dealt a devastating blow on economic activities in the state, gave rise to restlessness, underdevelopment, destruction of people's legitimate means of livelihood, and the needless loss of lives. Sadly, too, there was a higher degree of proliferation of firearms. This development bears an unprecedented hunger regime and unemployment across all working age groups in the state. Ladies and gentlemen, Zamfara state has become notorious for vices that defy all known logic. The insecurity in the state has assumed a dangerously galloping dimension, prior to the assumption of office of His Excellency, Right Honorable Bello Muhammadu Matawalle, the governor of the state. Worried by this development, the current state governor, immediately commenced the search for an enduring peace and also rid the state of all forms of crimes. This was in clear recognition that something new needed to be deployed. Wisdom came into bear, and the governor opted for cloak and dagger approach in dealing with this brand of crime that was fast growing in a geometric progression. The correct approach was to dialogue with the repentant bandits with the view to reintegrate them into the society, while the dagger approach was to ensure that the unrepentant bandits face the full weight of the law. It is important to state unequivocally that the governor Bello Matawalle clearly inherited a state with total collapse of security, and the best option was to think outside the box. It was crystal clear that using the same old methods and processes will provide no new and desired results. Let me repeat that loneliness, rape, kidnapping, banditry, as well as high robbery in Zamfara state had assumed an alarming proportion and posed great dangers to all and sundry, regardless of tribe, religion, social standing, and political affiliations. The process of the peace initiative and dialogue with repentant bandits was activated immediately. The governor equally sought, it is wise, to roll out other measures that will address the real causes of cattle rustling, which metaphors into full banditry. He recognized the fact that there should be an end to the needless loss of lives and destruction of people's livelihood. Governor Tolle fully understood that to achieve an enduring peace and success, there was need to develop a proper program that will replace open grazing into the state and put an end to the persistent farmers' harassment prediction, as well as cattle rustling. It was not wise to shake hands with a clenched fist. In the words of Martin Luther King Jr., true peace is not merely the absence of tension, it is the presence of justice. To this end, the governor quickly proposed to establish one rural grazing ground, that is Ruga, in each of the three senatorial districts of the state. Of the state with modern facilities that will usher in a 21st century method of cattle rearing and product development. The Ruga project guarantees an all-year-round grazing with nutritious grass, water canals, dams, houses, schools, hospitals, and veterinary clinics. Other facilities include police outpost, a mini stadium, as well as place of worship. And as we are speaking to you now, one of the rugas is about 100% completed. Whoever we want to see can go to Maradi local government. It is there for anybody to see. It is important to state that this and many other interventions have clearly reduced the killings and attacks in the state, who hitherto were daily occurrences. Today, people living in Zamfara state duly appreciate the genuine intentions and determination of the state governor to ensure an enduring peace, and the support is heartwarming. Gentlemen of the press, this peace initiative that allows repentant bandits to voluntarily surrender their arms and ammunition has undoubtedly ushered in a new dawn in the street. As we speak, people who have deserted their villages have started returning. Farmers have been returning to in droves to their farms. The roads are safer today. Markets have reopened and business activities have picked up. Peace is gradually returning to Zamfara. Frankly, it is important that we commend the approach of Governor Bello Matole. It is on this note that we throw our full support for the measures taken by the state governor in taming this menace. We are indeed elated that the governor went further to roll out various forms of palliative welfare packages as well as youth employment in the state. This foresight has helped greatly in addressing immediate needs of the people whose livelihood were destroyed in the wake of the attack. This and many more will no doubt reset the state on the path of development and ultimately drop an indelible mark on the sands of time. We appreciate our security forces who have keyed into this peace policy. We are grateful to everyone in Zamfara who have provided support for the success of this peace initiative, and also call on the federal government of Nigeria to borrow a leaf from the Zamfara State Peace Initiative to achieve national peace. It is our belief that the federal government should offer amnesty to those repentant bandits in the northwestern region, because we are convinced that these repentant bandits will be encouraged to contribute positively to society. Ladies and gentlemen, the current state of affairs in Zamfara state further convinces us that the peace cannot only be achieved by force. It is evidently clear that peace can also be achieved through understanding and genuine dialogue. This conviction comes on the heels of similar success recorded in the Niger Delta, where the late President Umaru Musa Yar'Adua grant amnesty to the repentant bandits in that region. Today, the story in that once troubled area is clearly not the same. The amnesty worked perfectly by turning the criminals minded into productive elements, and they are usefully contributing to the society in various fields of endeavor. Today, the attacks on critical infrastructures, including oil installations, pipeline vandalism, and the adoption of expatriates in the region have drastically reduced courtesy of the amnesty program. This is a testimony that peace cannot only be achieved through the use of excessive force. It is evident that dialogue and genuine commitment of both parties is also a vital tool in tackling insecurity. It is gratifying that there is an increase in oil production in the region following the takeoff of the amnesty program in the Niger Delta region. The provision of scholarship for repentant militants as well as unemployment are some of the success of the amnesty, and this has returned peace to the area and the Nigeria in general. We can achieve same peace in the Northwest region if the federal government extends this olive branch to repentant bandits. We equally call on other states in the Northwest region of this country to also initiate peace dialogue with the various states as a way of fighting these vices for the peace and development of the region. Because history has shown that no nation, state, or region can develop in the face of higher insecurity. We must work in unionism and patriotism to clear these hurdles for a better tomorrow, so that history will judge us kindly. Desmond Tutu says, and I quote, "If you want peace, you don't talk to your friends, you talk to your enemies." So there is absolutely nothing wrong in pursuing peace through dialogues with repentant bandits who are prepared to be reintegrated into the society. We therefore appeal to all governors of the Northwest, regardless of their political party affiliations, to confront banditry using Governor Bertone's model. We need to work for peace for the future by changing the mindsets of the bandits, creating employment opportunities for the youth, and resolving the very issues that could potentially trigger crimes. We call on all hands to be on deck. This is not about the personal interests of the president, governor, or anyone of us here. It is about ridding our region of these vices and making the region safer, prosperous, and peaceful. This is about returning the entire region to its good old days, where everybody moved freely and conducted his or her legitimate business without any fear of being taken into the forest or killed or raped. What we experience today does not represent what we are, and we must come together to move away from it. It is disheartening, and we must work assiduously to right this set of wrongs and ills in our society. Ladies and gentlemen, so much is expected of our leaders, and we must all rise to the occasion. We must make decisions that will serve the general interest of Nigeria, and the time is now. The Zamfara State Governor has provided a workable model, and it is our conviction that if replicated in all the states of the Northwest and Nigeria in general, we will be in a better and stronger tomorrow. Gentlemen of the press, we thank you for your attention and listening. Thank you.
Okay, Punch.